Hello everybody, Nick here, and welcome back to some more City Skylines After Dark. We are back in our city of Springfield, which is what I decided to call it for now, because I am horrible at coming up with names. And yeah, we're gonna, you know, continue having to build up the city a little bit, because, you know, kind of nice to, you know, actually be able to do stuff with the city rather than, you know, just, you know, looking at regular old stuff that was here to begin with other than the Daylight Cycle, which is cool. Yeah, because there's quite a few other features that come along with this game too, and obviously we need to actually get to a certain point so we can unlock them, which I kind of want to get done sooner rather than later. Because, you know, kind of the point. So yeah, I'm gonna, you know, do need a little bit more of the industrial area, so I'm gonna, you know, expand the Chestnut District here a little bit, because it kind of needs some expanding going on. And yeah. Let's get ourselves a few more buildings this way. And kind of liking how the city's turning out so far. I mean, yeah, this road kind of neat. It's gonna have to get widened at some point to one lane, two lanes each direction, or we could, you know, say, take this, turn it one way, and then branch maybe, like, another one-way road off, like, over to this side, make this the one-way go in the opposite direction. And so I got choices there, but yeah, that's kind of, I think I'll leave this for now, just because, you know, people do have two options. They can also go up here and go around, so. But yeah, I do think I kind of want to at least put a little bit of commercial right here along the area here leading up to the bridge. Maybe give ourselves something to, you know, work with, and also we can put in some roads up here, because roads are awesome. Yeah. Actually, I think these power lines are gonna get in the way. So we're going to not do that. We're going to go here, take the power line and go across like that. So that way, this power line can get destroyed. And because it's all connected up there, we can zone this area out easily. Unlike before, when it was kind of a little difficult to do. The other thing, I think this waterfront area, I'm kind of going to want to, like, you know, I kind of want to do commercial here along the waterfront, so I'm gonna do it that way, and we'll just kind of, you know, put roads in where we need to. We can maybe get this road, kind of will stay here along the waterfront, go like that. And then I'm gonna want one to come in here somewhere and go through. Don't like that I can't put, like, just a road right through there, because apparently the windmills are in the way, and actually, we really don't need the windmill. Yeah, we do. At least for now. And we actually don't even have enough power. We might need a second one of these guys. And yeah, I suppose we'll just put you there. That should get us plenty of power for the city, assuming that we are budgeting for it. And let's budget our 100% back for that. And we should now be making plenty of power so we can get rid of these over here. And that destroys our little system of power over here. Lovely. Side effects. Side effects include loss of power. and your mom. Yes, the side effects include your mom. Waterfront area. I think that will be good for the grid back here. I'm gonna take the coastline here, and actually we're gonna put you into that over here, so we can do it that way, and that way we can do all of this. We'll get those there commercial, and I think this block I'm just gonna make all residential. So I have kind of a few more waterfront houses, but yeah, most of the waterfront will be commercial. So I think that makes good sense for it, and I'm already losing power. Let's get power back. Oh, lovely. Lots of abandoned buildings. Why were you abandoned? Worker education too low. I don't have the high school yet. I can build it now, though, so I think that's going to be the next thing I do. So, should I just put you right along the main road here? I think so. Put you kind of more down here. And that way it spreads out to a larger area. This corner isn't really captured, but as long as you have enough capacity, you're usually fine. Elementary school might need one more of those soon. Yeah, so everything's looking good so far in the city. I'm liking how it's progressing. It's a little bit interesting to kind of have the extra road here than just kind of do that, but. I don't think it's that big of a deal, and I'm gonna demolish these guys for now. The abandoned buildings, because they're abandoned. And hopefully we start educating these workers quick. Because I would like to keep these businesses and not, you know, have them destroyed because they abandoned. That would be preferable. Actually, I think we can go right up to the city border here. Nope, we need the one shorter. Right there. Yep, and zone you. Not you. Just you. Actually, even with that, we might want to put a road down the middle. Just kinda to get that zoning going, and we're gonna need a lot of this stuff anyway, so why not just get it ready to go? And we'll continue kind of doing that. There we go. Get ourselves a little bit of water so we can expand up here. And yeah, more you were abandoning because apparently we don't have enough education in this city. Sorry, we don't, because you know, you decide to come here and build and do stuff and things because reasons. That was a great formation of a sentence there, wasn't it? So yeah, kind of both of our districts are looking pretty nice so far. And we'll just kind of the Autumn District, I think, is going to continue to have this sort of shape to it. We'll have kind of just the regular grid, and then it'll join this road at kind of awkward angles, where Eden Square will kind of have it join more at this, like, trajectory that we have here going already, except for here along the river will also kind of a row of businesses, I guess. Except for that one right there, we can just do regular row, I think. And just kind of paint that in. Yeah. Yeah, and then the other thing I might want to do once we... Oh, wait, we have the footpaths already. Kind of thinking I want a bicycle path here along the water. I know it's not the most flat area, but I think it'd be kind of cool to have that. Bridge some odd reason. Actually, I'm kind of liking how it is forming the bridge, because even though it's forming a bridge, it's kind of also letting out the land it's on. Which is probably good. Even though it does weird stuff like that. I'm not sure about it, actually. Looking at that. We are gonna plant trees along it, though, for sure. That's for certain. Be a little bit careful where we plant the trees too, because like that one even looks a little not so healthy, because apparently that means it's too close to the water. Bring some of that in. And just kind of make the waterfront here look kind of nice. Ah, we really need to get rid of those power lines now, because we don't really need them. And let's get more of these. Put a few over two of those guys up here. And just kind of filling in the areas that are the hill here. It would be a really cool area to put, like, some stuff in, but I don't think it's gonna let us put, like, any really well-done paths in there, so without doing a serious amount of terraforming and that kind of stuff, so I think just this will be fine. Yeah, we just kinda, you know, fill in the hill. Sadly, we can't put any, like, trees or anything under the bridge. I think just some of these, like, lower ones would be really nice to do, but game won't let us, so oh well. And we just kind of continue filling in, like, this area. Oh, we did... Oh, I should point out our new milestone. We in town, which means we get new stuff like specializing in ore, we can buy another tile, And we have our cemetery that we need to deal with now, so let's at least get that down while we're working on the waterfront here, because cemetery isn't here. And I think maybe right there will be a good spot for it. Right in the middle of Dean Square. Sure, looks like a good spot for it. And we'll just get back to working on continuing to make this waterfront look pretty nice. That, yeah, there's someone there, okay. Just the commercial demand's kinda low right now. So they're not moving anything in there, which is fine. Just for the future, that's gonna be some more of that. See, I think this waterfront look could just be complete with if I could put these under the bridge. See, because, I mean, it just looks like it belongs there, and I can't put it there. And we'll kind of do the same thing on the other side when we get to the waterfront there, I believe. I think that's my plan for that, so... And traffic? How is traffic working? You know, we'll have here, apparently. That could just be... That's something. Yeah, I mean, it could mostly just... Oh, that car's parked. Never mind. I suppose traffic is coming around that way and going down, since the constant road, just like this one straight ahead, is. Actually, that might be the spot where we do it. We make this road go, like, one way in this direction, and this one goes one way around the outside here, down to the main road. That might be the best way of doing that. So it'd just be one way, both lanes to here, and then the only thing is this doesn't really make sense anymore, ending in two lanes going like that, because there's only one place where those cars can go to. Which, I mean, might be fine, but then also these roads, you're only able to approach it if you go around like this. Yeah, I think that's kind of what I want to do with it, though, because... Yeah, still be enough room for this block. I actually have a little bit of extra room then. This one, same kind of deal, we'll have, like, a little bit extra room back there for stuff, but... Yeah, we can worry about that later. Oh, and we need to get our water further down that way. About there? No, a little bit closer. Right about there. Yes. And you know what? I'm just gonna, you know, do that. And at least most of this map is ready for water already, because I always forget about it. For some odd reason. Doesn't matter how many times I play this game, I always forget to give water to people. And apparently people need water to grow. You know, even though they're not plants or anything, they still need water to grow. Because reasons. Yeah, I mean, this city is kind of a grid city, but not really. I usually like doing, like, my first area kind of gridded, and then when I expand onto the city, I tend to get rid of the grid after so long and kind of just do more crazy shapes with the grid, because I think that looks more realistic. Well, that's our police station, that's why that stuff's not zoned. Good for this district, and now this is another way to get to the high school, and you know what, I'm gonna leave that area open, put a little park here next to the high school, I think. Said little park, yeah, like that. Here, a playground. I think the playground is going to be school. I mean, you're too big. Plaza. That might make sense. Yeah, that looks fine there. And this side will just kind of fill with some trees or something, I think. To give the school a little bit of breathing room here. And apparently kids go to school at night in this game, so there's that. I don't know why you would want to go to school in the middle of the night, but be my guest. Sunrise! Oh, we're running low on water. Wow. And sewage is kind of going low too. So let's take care of you. There we go. Oh right, budget wasn't 100% on those either, was it? Whoops! You just raised the budget. See, again, stuff I don't mess with because I forget about it. Yeah, so... Yeah, we really need to take care of that issue. There we go. I suppose we'll kind of turn that road a little bit. So that way we can, you know, fit more stuff back here. Going for the coal power plant was kind of an interesting idea. Or have ore over here. Don't really have much ore deposits though. Maybe up there too, but And I don't think that's going to be a big deal or anything, so... Now, also, did we unlock the highways? Yes, we did. Let's actually take the time to finally upgrade you to a highway road. And that also means we can finally do that one, too. So yeah, we're kinda... Here we're combining, here we're splitting. So each lane gets going a different direction. Here are both lanes kind of merge together. That's kind of how it works. It just allows the traffic to kind of flow a little bit smoother in and out, so that way it doesn't have to stop. Over here it's more of a, hey, this is an intersection, let's just do stuff. This little bit here, I think I'm gonna leave that like that, so that way both roads get to come on and then they have to combine. Here it's not that big of a deal because you can turn either lane and go across and into the city. River road, I should say. And yeah, as you kind of get closer to... And when you get up to the river, it kind of starts diverging a little bit, so... That way you can kind of get some... stuff in here, and... I think it's kind of nice having the businesses up against the water, but... I don't know if I... And I think I'm gonna go out to there and like that, maybe, for a block? Do something a little bit different there? Oh yeah, that looks nice, I think. This all back here we can fill in with green. This up here will be blue. This over here is not going to be anything yet. Also, it makes kind of sense that we are going to want to fill in, like, blank areas like this with some trees. I think that will kind of make it look more like it's a continuous area rather than just random stuff placed around. You know, because we don't want the city to look like random stuff just plopped in. I want it to make it look like it just all kind of goes together. Another big thing I would like to do, if it's possible, is to see if I could get past and kind of come back here. I don't know how easy that would be to do, though, without... I think I'm... will work, but... I There we go. Need a flat path, and well, this doesn't want to form a flat path, so I'm gonna force it to form a flat path. The only thing that sucks about doing it this way is there's not really any way in or out here. Which there kind of needs to be. Yeah, that's just not good enough. I kind of wish it would kind of like try to flatten out these paths when you place them, but it doesn't for some bizarre reason. That makes sense, doing that, I suppose. This is not, though. Oh, neither. No. Ugly. It that way, and you're trying to do the same thing here, I suppose. Yeah, that's better, I think. Yeah, that looks better. That's kind of more along the edge here, rather than just... We can just sneak you right down the middle there. And you up there. Yeah, the ends of these roads are kind of... get a little bit of a pathway here that... I feel like the ends of roads, and... you can just walk right on by, and... I think having that little trail there is kind of a cool little thing. We'll just, you know, put some trees along it, make it look... kind of like it belongs, and... kind of a quiet little path here. You know, for bikes and that to walk go along some. And it just kind of connects out here to the main road and all that kind of stuff. So, yeah, I like it. I need to do more of these, like, paths, kinda. maybe over here in, like, Valley Square or something, maybe we, like, put, like, paths between, like, all the houses or something. Be kind of a cool little challenge to do, and kind of connect stuff up a little bit differently. I like that idea, but anyways, we are out of time for this episode. Surprisingly, I know, right? Where does the time go? So anyways, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!